Marylanders have cast their votes and have decided to send Governor O'Malley back to the statehouse. With 99% of precincts reporting, the current governor handed former Governor Bob Ehrlich a defeat in their much-publicized rematch. More than 963,000, or 56% of votes, favored O'Malley over Ehrlich, who received 42% of ballots cast. We begin our Commitment 2010 team coverage with Jennifer Franciotti, who's live in our newsroom with more on the governor's sound victory. Jen?
Good afternoon, Sarah. At his victory party last night, the governor thanked his supporters, and he reached out to those who voted for Republican challenger Bob Ehrlich. This morning, the governor and other top names in Maryland Democratic politics made stops in Baltimore to say thank you to the voters who kept them in office.
Standing on the corner of North Avenue and Druid Hill Avenue, Governor Martin O'Malley held a thank you sign, waving to supporters who honked a greeting in return. O'Malley will spend 4 more years in office after soundly beating Republican challenger Bob Ehrlich.
Feels great. Good to be in the city of Baltimore. We had a great night yesterday. It was a disappointing night across the country, but in Maryland, we chose as a people to move forward.
But moving forward will be difficult, says Democratic U.S. Congressman Elijah Cummings, who easily took the 7th District. With the Republican majority now in the House following Tuesday's election, he says time will tell.
But I think all of us need to step back and say it's not about who we were running against, but who we are fighting for. And that's, I'm hoping that we'll all just take a deep breath and do what's necessary. The other thing that we got to keep in mind is that Republicans can no longer just blame this president. They can no longer stand on the sidelines saying no. Now they have to be a part of the solution. So we'll see.
Meanwhile, Senator Barbara Mikulski, who won with 62% of the vote, waved to her supporters during the morning rush in downtown Baltimore. Mikulski says jobs are a top priority.
We've got a big job ahead. We've got to really have a stronger economy. We've got to focus on creating jobs, keeping the jobs we have in this country, getting rid of the tax breaks that send jobs overseas, and getting our kids ready for the future economy.
And as for the future of former Governor Bob Ehrlich, he told supporters last night this chapter in his life is now closed. Reporting live here in the newsroom, Jennifer Franciotti. Sarah, back to you.